Okay, so this is Windows on Raspberry Pi, episode 35. We've just had another update, and this is a big one. We have HDMI audio. Now, I'm on my 8GB Pi 4 at the moment, and as you can see, I'm running YouTube, so if I just hit the space bar, you can hear the audio is fine. No crackles, no pops, lovely and clear, and coming through HDMI. We already had it on 3.5mm audio before, but this could mean a big thing for the Pi 400. I haven't tried it yet, but I'm going to try it in a minute. Let's switch into screen capture. So thanks to Chris Eric for letting me know about this. It is definitely a great update. As I say, I haven't tried it on the Pi 400 yet, but it's working fine on the Pi 4. So if I click on this down the bottom here, you can see that I can switch between different audio devices. So that's the 3.5mm output and also the HDMI audio. And if I have a look at the Discord, so driver updates, there's a GitHub on it. This will tell me what the fixes are. So version 0.12, it's automatically applied by the WR tool, which I'll go through in a minute. It does say Raspberry Pi 4 400, initial support for HDMI audio at 16-bit, 44,100 Hz. HDMI 0, which is the normal HDMI we would use anyway. Analog audio improvements, fix clicks, pops before and after playback. Increased depth from 11-bit to 13-bit. And Bluetooth now runs at the maximum board of, 3 million, with hardware flow control enabled. Really good to see. So this update is particularly good news for people who have Pi 400s, because the Pi 4 has always had 3.5mm support, or really for quite some time, so you've been able to use that as an audio connection. But we don't have that luxury on the Pi 400, so connectivity-wise, there is no analog jack. So let's give this a test. It says it works, so I'm sure it will. Let's shut down and switch over all the cables. So let's get rid of this one. I'm using the Samsung Bar 128GB to do this. It's really good for an operating system. It's faster than most of the SD cards. Not as fast as SSD, but also very compatible as well. And this is definitely one of the more annoying things about Windows, the fact that it has to apply these updates. I wish it was more like macOS or a lot of Linux distros, where it allows you to do the update when you want to do it, because this has been doing this for a couple of minutes now. Anyway, let's plug in my mouse. I can switch over the Ethernet cable. Okay, so that stopped flashing. So HDMI, USB-C, and the USB stick, which has got the operating system on it. Plug the operating system into one of the USB 3 sockets. Okay, and that seems to be starting up all right. Okay, so I've done a test and I can't get any audio to work, but that could be because I set this up on a Raspberry Pi 4 and not the Pi 400, so it still says Pi 4 here. I've tried both of these settings, I've tried playing around, I've tried going into Device Manager, and everything I try, I can't seem to get it to work. But maybe I can manually install the drivers. I haven't tried that yet, but I guess this is probably an unusual case, because most people would install it and use it on the system they're using it on, not switch between Pi 400 and Pi 4. So let me know how you get on if you install it on a Pi 400 fresh. I would imagine then the audio is going to work. The things that still aren't working, so there is no onboard Wi-Fi, so I'm using an Ethernet cable, but Wi-Fi isn't supported yet on the Pi 4 or the Pi 400. I have plenty of videos with good options around it, and in fact, so this one here, this working Wi-Fi adapter, I also had a Wi-Fi workaround using a smartphone as an internet connection. Both of these are ways of getting around it. This Vonage adapter is superb, and if I show you a picture of it, so this is what it looks like. It is USB powered, and it basically gives you a Wi-Fi connection in an Ethernet port. So you can use that with both the Pi 400 and the Pi 4 and pretty much anything else. Now, my son's gaming computer upstairs, he's been using this for the last few months because his home plug adapter failed. And so I said, oh, just try this and it will get you through it, figuring it'll be too slow and he'll look for another option. He's just left it as it is, and he reckons he's had the best internet he's had for a while. So yeah, I've lost this adapter to my son for the moment. And we're a long way from, I can't believe how many Windows on Raspberry Pi videos I've done, but if you're interested in what runs on it, have a look through this playlist. Yeah, back along, I actually ended up powering with two power adapters. So we're a long way past that, and we're nearly there. We're nearly everything working. GPU's not supported. Onboard Bluetooth, I think, yeah, this was my setup. So this was, that's an SSD drive there. So I was powering my Pi through the GPIO pins, but I was also using a power adapter as well. It was working well, and I wasn't getting any error messages, and I was able to overclock. But as I say, we're a long way past that now. What was that? That was episode, I guess. Well, I didn't number it, look. So 7.5, I guess. So if I close this down and do a search for Bluetooth, so if I press the Windows key, or a Raspberry in the case of the Pi 400, and do a search for Bluetooth, you can see Bluetooth comes up, and if I do add device and Bluetooth, it just comes up with an issue. I have a Sabrent Bluetooth adapter, which is also in one of my playlists, and I'll put a link in the description. But that gives you Bluetooth support, and Bluetooth audio works, Bluetooth controllers, all sorts of things work as well. So if you need Bluetooth, you need a separate Bluetooth adapter. So I have a video on installing this with a Raspberry Pi 4, but I use the method I've used more, which is installing with a Windows computer, and I'm using my little Melee mini PC to do this. Okay, so let's write the same OS to the Samsung bar, but this time I'm going to start it up in the Pi 400 and see if that makes the difference. So let's double click on the WOR folder. This is exactly the same method as in this video, Windows 11 install, nothing different to this at all. So run as administrator. I can't remember if you need to do it as administrator, but I'm going to do it anyway. And next, Raspberry Pi 4, select my drive, handily with the Samsungs, they come up as Samsung. Image file. So this is the ISO I've created using the same method in this Windows 11 video. So Windows 11 Home comes up, hit next, use the latest package, and next, use the latest firmware, and next again, and install. And when that's all done, I can boot it all up in the Pi 400. Okay, so it's all booted up now on the Pi 400 as a clean install. I've plugged it into the other HDMI socket and it seems to be working now. So if I press the play button, you can hear that the sound is coming out of the speaker. It's coming out of the HDMI socket. It actually, in this setup, it goes through my capture device, but it's proving that it's going through HDMI because no sound would come out of here if it wasn't coming out of HDMI. So anyway, thanks very much to everybody at the WOR team and everybody at the Discord who's got involved in this. A great job. It keeps getting better and better. Thanks very much for watching. Please like and subscribe.